Leo, these are your cards for the first week of April from the Mystical Lenormand Fortune Telling Deck. So we are looking at you weighing out what's being offered to you here with the Ring card, and that's representative of Taurus energy. So we could be dealing with a Taurus, or we could just be dealing with this type of energy, right? And then this is 25, so we're talking about sharing, and we're talking about awareness of sharing, okay? And what that means. We're talking about maybe there's some anxiety or some nervousness here. It's like Uranus is here, which is talking about something changing or needing to change something or just changing something, a shift of perspective, right? Uranus is here talking about a change, a shift of perspective, something being different. And this card is number 12, right? And that 12 reduces to a 3. And that 3 is talking about, you know, the possibilities for things to change and shift at any given moment, right? And there's a little bit of instability here with this change and this shift. So you might be feeling like that, you know, just kind of like affected by the change or by the shift, because it's owls, and owls talk about the nervousness from Uranus coming in. And then the 3 is the third house of Gemini, which was ruled by Mercury. Mercury and Uranus is the higher octane of Mercury. Okay, so there could be a lot of nervousness going on in your head, a lot of busy thinking going on in your head. You know, Uranus rules Aquarius, and Aquarius is a thinker. You know, it's an air sign. So this could just be you thinking about, you know, you're nervous about the responsibilities or about what it is that you have to sort of like comply with. It's kind of like, you know, because it's like Uranus doesn't want to comply with a certain reality or a certain shift, but then it's saying that you're going to have to adapt. It's a higher understanding of how to adapt to a change or a shift, but the change and the shift is so extreme and so radical. It's Uranus, and Uranus is actually in Taurus right now, and that squares you. You know, it's I believe, is that what house is that from you, Leo? Is that your 10th house? No. I'm going to have to count those houses back. But Taurus is here in your reading right next to Uranus, you know? And Taurus does not like that energy. Taurus does not like that energy of Uranus, because Uranus is actually exalted in Scorpio. And speaking of that energy of Scorpio, it squares you as well. But Uranus likes being in Scorpio, because Uranus is very potent there. So there's some potent energy here for you to allow that radical shift to really kickstart, to really push forward this transformative energy. There's a detoxifying of some old structures that are occurring here, and that's why this Taurus card came up in the center, because that talks about tradition, and it talks about ways that you have understood things to be that you may have complied with, you know, because you just did. It was your reality, and your reality changed here with this Uranus card. It brought about a little bit of nervousness, uneasiness, and it's about thinking outside the box. It's about thinking about ways to sort of do something that makes you feel powerful, right? That's why Uranus is exalted in Scorpio, because that there's a need to make, to let something shift, let something change, or let something just kind of like turn over that needs to turn over, you know. This number 8, This coffin is in a tomb. So it's like you could be keeping something trapped. You could be keeping something locked in that wants to get out. And that's why it talks about, you know, disease and toxicity, because that wants to get out. But then it also talks about creativity with this 8 being here, because, you know, that's related to the 8th house, you know. But Pluto rules the 8th house, and Pluto is exalted in Leo, which is talking about creativity. But the number eight, the coffin, it talks about sickness, it talks about disease and things like that, viruses, you know. So it's like very corona related, because that's what changed, that's what shifted things for you. It could even been in the job, you know what I mean, that type of thing. Some of you might not even be affected by it because you're able to work over the internet. You know what I mean? You could even be thinking of ways to kind of like do some stuff over the internet that's going to bring in something for you with this ring, because this ring is an offering, and ring is something that's of value. And Taurus does talk about value. And then it's 25, and that's a 7. The 7th house of Libra, weighing things out, value, market systems, you know, what's being fair. You get what you give, right? So you've got to give something to get something. What is it that you are going to give, right?